This is a setup for the gas constant lab, and the first thing that we'll be doing is measuring out a piece of magnesium. I've got attached to this piece of cardboard a length of magnesium that weighs about 0.035 grams and another one that weighs about 0.045 grams. We want the mass of our magnesium to be somewhere in between there, ideally somewhere in the 0.040 gram region. So I'm going to cut off a piece of magnesium that is about that length. So I will use scissors here. You could just tear it with your fingers, but I think it's a bit easier or a bit more accurate using scissors here. So I'm just going to cut a piece and hopefully it'll be, hopefully it will lie in length between those two, and it does. That's good, that's what we want. So now we're going to take that and we're going to weigh it. So here's my cut piece of magnesium. It says in the directions it's probably a good idea to sand it as well. That's before you weigh it. Then after you've sanded it, you can put it on the balance and just note the mass. It should be somewhere between 0.035 grams and 0.045 grams. Right, so this is the length of copper wire that we're going to use. As you can see, it's quite skinny. Now this is important because what's going to happen is I'm going to have to put this into the eudiometer tube with a stopper. If it's too thick, there's a good chance it'll break the end of the tube once the pressure of the stopper hits it. So if I have a skinny wire like this, there's much less of a chance of that happening. Over here I've got my magnesium that I cut earlier. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap this around the copper wire, probably about 1 to 2 inches down from the top. No more than that, because I need a bunch of copper wire at the end. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and wrap this around the copper wire. My fingers are going to get in the way here a little bit. Sort of a loose-ish ball. Put this up like this as well. That will stop it from falling off the end. Alright, so this is what I've got so far. Put it here in the... Alright, so that's what I've got so far. Now what I want to do is I'll take this top part here, I'll wrap it around the magnesium, then I'll take a bit of the bottom part here and I'll wrap that around the magnesium as well. And this is how we'll get this copper cage for our piece of magnesium. This will stop it from floating up to the surface. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and start wrapping. See, I'm just wrapping it around the magnesium. So this is what I've got so far. Now I'm going to take some of this bottom part here. Not very much of it, mind you. I still want to be left with an appreciable length at the end. Fair amount at the end here so that I can stick that into the eudiometer tube. So just maybe about this much, that's what I'm going to wrap around the bottom of the magnesium here. Yeah. Kind of cross it over a bit, kind of like you're wrapping a present in a way. Alright, so there you go. That would be the magnesium, and that's going to be in a copper cage, and it's ready to put into the eudiometer tube. Notice again, there's a fair amount of copper left at the end that can go at the bottom of the tube. So what we're looking at here is what's called a eudiometer tube. It's closed at one end and open at the other end. And it's got these little graduations on here. I'm going to move this in closer to the camera so you can get a closer view of what the graduations look like. Now the unfortunate thing about a eudiometer tube is you would hope that the graduations were accurate and that they were exactly 1 milliliter, but unfortunately it turns out that they're not. So what this means is we have to calibrate it. The way we're going to calibrate this is we're going to use this kind of setup. This is a burette and it's been filled to 0.00 milliliters up here. Always make sure that the bottom of the meniscus is on the line as you would normally do. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to empty 40 mils or 40.00 mils or close to it into the Eudiometer tube. So that's what I'm going to do now. And as you can see, the best technique here is basically to use a burette stand and to have it hanging off the table rather than trying to lift up and do it that way. So I'm just going to put in about 40.00 mils. It doesn't have to be exactly that. Somewhere in the ballpark though. Now, what I'm adding from the burette is exact. There's no doubt about that. But what's going into the Eudiometer tube is not particularly exact. This is how we're going to calculate what's called a conversion factor to take account of the fact that the Eudiometer tube is not correctly graduated. All right, so I've added about 40 mils now. I will read the exact number off there, and that will be what I've put there. And then what I'll do is I will read off here what the Eudiometer tube is actually saying. Now I know it's upside down, but you should still be able to get a measurement based on that. Obviously, if you try and turn it the right way up, all the water will come out. Right, so we're going to add some 6 molar HCl to the Eudiometer tube. And this is 10 mils. It's not as bad as 12 molar, but I still like to use it near a fume hood. So I'm just going to go ahead and add the 6 molar HCl like this. And it sits in the bottom of the Eudiometer tube. What I'm going to do now is I've got some water here. It doesn't have to be DO water. Tap water should be okay. And I'm going to pour that into the Eudiometer tube so that the 6 molar HCl pretty much just stays on the bottom and doesn't mix too much with the water. So here we go. Just kind of doing it down the side a little bit. Notice I angle it just a tad. Just do it fairly slowly at first. And then we can fill it a bit faster as we go closer to the top. And you want to probably fill it maybe about an inch from the top, something like that. That'll be fine. We're going to put a stopper in this, so we need a little bit of space there. Right, and that's pretty much it. We've got this, and then we've got the HCl still on the bottom. Alright, so now I've got my magnesium in its little copper cage. I've got the Eudiometer tube, and in the Eudiometer tube we've got water layered on top of HCl. So I'm going to show you how we get the... move this down a little bit here. So you can see I've dipped this into the water, and I've crimped the wire over the edge here like this. I'm going to keep that like that, and I need to get my stopper. Is that in the shot? Okay. So just going to put this here. And make sure that, that's why it's really important to make sure this is a very skinny piece of copper tubing. Because if this is too thick, as soon as you put this in here and it puts pressure on the side of the Eudiometer tube, it could break the Eudiometer tube. So only skinny copper wire here should be used. Now this stopper, I don't know if you can see that, also has a hole in it. It has a hole in it. If you don't have a hole in this, obviously pressure will build up and the whole thing will pop out. So there definitely needs to be a hole in it so that the pressure can build up in here and water can get out of the Eudiometer tube. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this over here. Is that in the shot? Okay. and I'm going to flip this and then clamp it in here and put it under the level of the water in this beaker. Okay, I'm going to keep my finger on the stopper here, make sure it doesn't come out, and away we go. So the bottom of the Eudiometer tube just has to be under the level of the water. I'm going to clamp it in there like that. Now what's going to happen is that the HCl is going to begin to diffuse down here. You might even begin to see it kind of diffuse. You might see some little layering going on. And then as soon as it begins to hit the magnesium here, it will begin to react. So Tyler, I'm going to ask you to zoom in here where my finger is. Okay. And what we're seeing here, or should be seeing, is the magnesium beginning to react. And you can see it starting to bubble, which is good. Just keep it here for a little bit. You can watch it react a bit more. And this is just because the HCl now is hitting that magnesium. All right, Tyler, I'm going to ask you to move the camera up to where my finger is here. And what we can see is that the headspace here, this hydrogen bubble that we're forming, is getting larger and larger. Now, I'd like you to move back down here to show the reaction of magnesium. So as you can see here, the magnesium is beginning to react much more vigorously with the HCl. And this is what's going to happen as time goes on. You can see now why it was necessary for us to keep the magnesium in a copper cage. Because what can happen is that the magnesium can leave the copper and then head up here and then perhaps get stuck to the side and not react. So we need something to sort of hold it in there. Copper won't react with the HCl, but the magnesium definitely will, and you can see that that's exactly what's happening here. Tyler, would you move up here? As you can see, the hydrogen is forming much more quickly now, and you can see as I follow my finger down here, it looks to me, could you please zoom in on that, Tyler? Looks to me like the magnesium is completely gone now, and we're in a position of being close to be able to make a measurement. We still have need to do one more step here. We need to let this cool for a few minutes, and then at some point after a few minutes it's cooled, we can push this down and equalize the pressure. So what we're looking at now is the step where we have to equalize the pressure. As you can see, the liquid here level is above the liquid level in the beaker that I've got here. So what I'm going to do is simply take this and then lower it so that the levels of the beaker and what's in the Eudiometer tube are going to be equal. Because once that happens, it means the pressure inside the tube and pressure outside the tube are equal, and now we can take a measurement in our Eudiometer tube for the hydrogen bubble. And if this doesn't stay like this after a few minutes, then you would do it again after a few minutes and equalize the levels. So that's what I'll do if this changes.